Handicapper Steve here, handicapping the racing from Saratoga Racecourse here on Saturday to September the 1st, 2018. I'm going to look at all the stakes races on today's program from Saratoga, but before I get on to that, remember to please follow me on Twitter at HorseRacingKid5 for more selections for racecourses around the world. It's Woodward Day from Saratoga, and the Woodward's great prep race for the Breeders' Cup Classic. As you know, last year Gunrunner won this race and went on to win the Classic, and then went on to win the Pegasus World Cup at Gulfstream in January. So, great race here. Good prep races for the Breeders' Cup at the end of the year. I'm going to look at, including the Woodward, I'm going to look at all the other stakes races, the Saranac, the Spinaway, and the Glens Falls. So, let's get to those races. They're all conveniently packed into an all-stakes pick four also, which I really like, so let's get to it. Races 9 through 12. The ninth race from Saratoga is the Saranac Stakes, grade 3, purse $300,000. This race is for three-year-olds here. Field of 9 horses going the distance of ground of 1,800 meters, or the distance of ground of 1 mile and one-eighth on the Mellon Turf Course. 1,800 meters, a mile and eighth on the Mellon. Top selection in this race, I like the number 4 horse here, the 4 horse Golden Brown. Gonna go 4-9-3-1 in the superfecta. 4-9-3-1 super. In the pick 4, I'm gonna go 4-9, but my top selection is the 4 horse Golden Brown, 3-year-old colt by Awfully Wild. Jario Rendon is on this one for Patrick McBurney. The horse's most recent outing came 29th of July at Monmouth, mile and 8th in the Haskell. I think it was the wrong race for this one. He finished 5th by 13 3/4 lengths. Very wide, stalked early on, but then he just kind of hit the wall. It wasn't the day to win. I think coming back to turf, which is this horse's preferred surface, I like his chances a lot more here than I would in, on a dirt, surface. Before that, though, this horse ran 2 weeks before the Haskell. He ran at Delaware July the 14th, mile and eighth on the turf course in the Kent Stakes, grade 3 Kent. This horse upset it that day. It won at 15-1, won by 1 3/4 lengths. He stalked most of the race, closed up well at the end, and got there. Good victory for this horse. And then before that, in his turf debut at Monmouth, mile 16th and a Dan Horn, June the 17th, horse finished second by a half length. Had a really good turn of foot from the mid-pack that day. Just missed again, but it was a very good run in his turf debut. And then at Monmouth, 26th of May, 6 furlongs in an allowance race, 51,000. Horse won by a neck there. It was a sprinting race, but it was quite an amazing run. Not a lot of horses at Monmouth close up the way he did. He got there at the end, closing up from the backpack. A really good victory. As we all know, Monmouth's main track is speed, speed, speed. So for a horse to close up, he did well there. And then before that, at Monmouth, 5.5 in the allowance race, 49 grand. First start since February. He needed the race, finished 4th by 2 1/4 lengths, didn't break all that well, and was wide, and like I said, needed the race. But I think the return to turf here today, firm ground, good post draw, I think he'll run a big one here today, so he'll be definitely used as a top selection and also be used on my pick 4, along with the 9 horse Maraud. 9-2 here, this 3-0 colt by Blame. I Rider T's Junior's on this one for Todd Pletcher. The horse's most recent outing came the 3rd of August here at Saratoga, a mile and 16th yielding ground in the Grade 2 Hall of Fame. This horse finished second by a nose there. He got caught right at the wire, closing up well. He just missed, but he ran his heart out there. I think his preferred, ground going is firm. Well, not a rock hard firm, but a good to firm, which you'll probably see today because you did get some rain earlier in the week. It's not going to be, firm ground like you saw last week, but it's going to be, good to firm, a little bit of a given in it. And, I think he'll really like that. But, that Hall of Fame was an improvement off his start before, which came at Belmont and the Belmont Derby, monoquarter inner turf course, July 7th. Horse finished 6 by 7 lengths, was very wide and just had nothing. You want to save ground on the inner turf course at Belmont and you want to sit closer. This horse did nothing of the sort. So it wasn't the day to win. And then before that, Penn National, firm ground, 1 mile, June the 2nd in the Penn Mile. Horse finished 4th by 3 1/4 lengths. He dueled early on, which is kind of different for this horse, which probably cost him at the end. He just kind of weakened out of it. It wasn't the day to win. It wasn't John Velasquez's best ride there, I must say. Not to knock the veteran, but, I wouldn't put that on the highlight reel. But before that, John Velasquez rode a great race in the American Turf on this one at Churchill, yielding ground a mile 16th, May the 5th. Horse won by 1.5 lengths from a wide post draw. Knew the best part of the race course was the 5 pass. He closed up well, and he got there at the end. Good turn of foot for this horse there in the American Turf. Before that, he won the Palm Beach very nicely, and then, he did well at Gulfstream over the winter. He's already a winner on this turf course, winning just under a year ago. September the 2nd of last year, he broke his maiden here at Saratoga, mile 16th in Maine Special. He won by 2 lengths, closing up well from a wide post draw. I like this horse a lot here today. At 9-2, he's a horse I'll definitely use on my pick four also. So to recap my selections for the 9th from Saratoga, it's the Grade 3 Saranac. Going to go as a top selection of four horse, Golden Brown. I'm going to go 4-9-3-1 in the Superfecta. I'll go 4-9 in my pick four. So now let's get on to race number 10 from Saratoga. It's the Spinaway Stakes, Grade 1 purse, $350,000. This race is for fillies 2-year-olds here. Field of 12 horses going the distance of ground of 1,400 meters, if you want to go with that, or the distance of ground of 7 furlongs on the Saratoga main track. 1,400 meters, 7 furlongs. And I show the diagram. It just gives me a second to look down at my notes. Just bear with me. Sorry, I'm stupid. I can't do two things at the same time. My top selection here, I like the number 5 horse, Nona Madeline. I'm going to go 5-7-4-3 in the Superfecta. 5-7-4-3 Super. In the pick 4, I'm going to go 5-7-4. So 5-7-4 in the pick 4. But my top selection to 5 horse, Nona Madeline. There's 2 hopefully by Candy Ride here. John Velasquez gets the leg up for Todd Pletcher. The horse's most recent outing came the 20th of July at Saratoga, 6 furlongs in the Grade 3 Skylaville. This horse just ran absolutely crappy at the beginning of the race, shall I say. He finished second by 4.5 lengths, and this horse possibly could have won if this horse had a better break. Broke absolutely a few steps slow that day. Then, you know, stumbled also. You know, it was a horrible break. But this horse, you know, he did have a decent turn of foot at the end. But like I said, if this horse broke better, I think she could have won. But before that, she ran up Monmouth, 5 furlongs, main special weight, 36,000. She was the best horse by a mile there. She won by 3 1/4 lengths there. Again, didn't break all that well, but had a great turn of foot around the 3/8 pole. And then just took off clear in the straightaway. Good race for this horse. Hopefully they figured out the braking for this horse today, because if she breaks well, she's going to win by a mile, I think, personally. But she's been training well here at Saratoga. Most recent workout, 4 furlongs, 49.3 last Saturday, 13th best workout, 35, and another Saratoga workout, 5 furlongs in a minute flat, 40. Best out of 30 out of 30 that afternoon. So, you know, I think this horse is rearing to go. Like I said, if this horse breaks well, going to win by a mile. I know I'm repeating myself, but I really think this horse is a decent, you know, good horse. So watch out for her here today. Also, in the future, the longer the race is, the more she's going to like it. I think 7 furlong might be a little bit too short, but in the future, she's going to really like those mile and 16th and mile and 8th races. She's a horse probably good for the Demoiselle in December at Aqueduct, but she'll run well here today also. But so I'll use her as a top selection. Another horse I'll use here is the 7 horse Chase. Yesterday, this 2-year-old filly by Tappet. Mike Smith comes in from Southern California to ride this Bob Baffert trained 2-year-old filly by Tappet. You know, this horse has only started once. That was the 28th of July at Del Mar, 5.5 furlongs in main special weight for 60,000. This horse won by 4.25 lengths there. Broke well, you know, sat back early, but got the lead around the top of the lane and then took off clear. Could have won by more, but Mike Smith didn't want to kill the poor horse. It was a very good victory. Since then, this horse has been training very well at Del Mar. Most recent workout was last Friday, 6 furlongs and 1.13 flat from the gate. The best workout, 13 out of 3 that day, shall I say. And at Del Mar workout, 6 furlongs and 1.13 flat, 17th of August. Third best out of 10 that day. You know, he's been, like I said, been training well since the last race. Ship around the country, I don't, you know, it should be good for this horse, because the, you know, the Bob Baffert horses have been shipping well, but you still never know, because this horse is a 2-year-old. But you know, I still think she'll most likely run well. 5-2 ship price, but you should have her on the pick 4, so watch out. And another horse I'll use on the pick 4 will be the number 4 horse here, Catherine the Great. 2-year-old filly by and captured here. Jose Ortiz gets leg up for Mark Cassie. This horse's most recent outing came in the Skylaville a few weeks ago here at Saratoga, 6 furlongs, July the 20th. This horse won by 4.5 lengths there. You know, again, didn't break all that well, but after the break, got sent to the lead and then didn't look back. Opened up by a bunch. A good race for this horse there. First stakes victory. Before that at Gulfstream, Sloppy Seal going 5 furlongs, June the 23rd, and a main special weight, 66,000. Horse won by 10.25 lengths there. But, you know, she won by a lot, but she had a horrible break. She didn't break all that well. But she went straight to the lead afterwards and just destroyed that subpar group of horses. Really good race there in her second outing. And then 26th of May at Gulfstream, 5 furlongs, main specialway, 55,000. Horse finished second by 5.5 lengths. A little bit wide, and, you know, she probably needed the race for experience. But, you know, her last two were very nice. If she breaks well, I think she's another horse that could really run a big one. So watch out for her. She'll be a horse I'll definitely use on the pick four. So to recap my selections for the 10th from Saratoga, it's the grade one Spinaway. Top selection, I'm going to go to the 5 horse, Nona Madeline. I'm going to go 5-7-4-3 in the Superfecta. I'll go 5-7-4 in my pick four. So now let's get on to today's featured 11th race. Race number 11 from Saratoga. It's the feature race. It's the Woodward Stakes presented by Naira Betts. It's a grade one race here. Going for a purse is $750,000. This race is for three-year-olds and upwards. Full starting gate of 14 horses going to the post. The distance of ground of 1,800 meters, or the distance of ground of 1 mile and 1/8. One lap around the Saratoga main track. 1,800, 1 mile and 1/8. Can't remember the last time there was a full starting gate of 14 horses going 1 mile and 1/8 at Saratoga. It's been a long, long time, but I like it a lot. And with that being said, you want a horse that has a low post draw. Wide post draw is probably not very good with that very quick run to the turn. Usually you want speed from the rail going 1 mile and 1/8 at Saratoga. And I have a horse that's probably on the brink of being outside to the inside. I like, as a top selection here, I like the 7 horse Kurilov. I think he's going to run a massive race. I'm going to go 7-1-4-9 in the Superfecta. 7-1-4-9 super. That's my top four, basically. In the pick four now, I'm going to go 7-1-4 in my pick four. But my top selection is 7 horse Kurilov, this Chilean bred 5-year-old horse here by looking at Lucky. Jose Ortiz gets leg up for Chad Brown. This horse's most recent appearance came the 5th of August at Saratoga, 1 mile and 1/8 in the Alidar. This horse finished second by head there, a little bit wide. After stalking most of the race, got the lead and opened up by a few, but then got caught right at the wire by Realm. He ran his heart out there, but today if he wants to win, he's going to have to, you know, wait a little later to get the good closing kick. But, that was his first race on dirt, first start on dirt this year. His last start on dirt came quite a while ago, and we'll get to that in a second. But before the Alidor, this horse ran in the United Nations at Monmouth Mile 3/8, June the 30th. Horse finished 8th by 7.5 lengths there. And he just never had that good closing kick. Sat 4th or 3 lengths off the pace most of the race. And just, you know, he never got there. It wasn't the day to win. Speed was really holding up on that turf course that afternoon. The winner, Fantastic, I believe, was on the lead all throughout. This horse just wasn't catching him. And then before that, at Belmont, a mile and a quarter inner turf course, May 25th, an obsolete claimer. Horse won by neck. He closed up from mid-pack there to get the victory in a dead heat with Profiteer. A really good turn of foot for this horse there. And then before that, in the Turf Classic, Churchill, mile and 1/8, May the 5th. He finished 8th by 12 and a quarter lengths. And, you know, the grass was probably too wet for him. And, he just didn't do well there. But his last dirt run in 2017 came the Queens County at Aqueduct on the main track. Mile and 1/8, sloppy going, December 23rd. Horse finished 3rd by a neck. It was an all-out finish. His horse just missed at the end, but he ran a great race in a second North America race. And then before that, at Aqueduct, 1 mile and obsolete claimer, he finished 4th by 2.25 lengths. He kind of weakened out of it. He needed the race since it was his first race in nearly a half a year. But I like him a lot here, going 1 mile and 1/8, second start on dirt of the season. 10-1, watch out for him to run a big one here. I think another horse that could run a big one is the one horse Yoshida, this 4-year-old colt by Heart City. Joe Rosario's on this one for Belmont. You know, this horse is a turf horse, but something you've been seeing the last 2 years at least at Saratoga, turf horses have been running very well on the dirt here. And last week, Catholic Boy, a few years ago, Good Samaritan won the Jim Dandy. I can't think of the other one. There was one more I thought of that a good turf horse won on the dirt. It's going to bother me now because I can't remember it. Another horse won on the turf. Another good stakes horse won on the, who's a turf horse, won on the dirt a few years ago here at Saratoga. So, you know, it's a good pattern that turf horses handle this dirt at Saratoga. And I think, like I said, Yoshida, I think he's going to run a big one in his dirt debut. 5-1 here. Joe Arsario, like I said, is riding this one. This horse had his first off the layoff most recently at Saratoga, the 11th of August, 1 mile inner turf course in the 4-star Dave, finished 5th by 3.75 lengths, and he needed the race. He was a little bit wide, and he never quickened up. I think second off the break, He should really do well. Before that, this horse ran at Royal Ascot, won Mom the Queen Anne. He finished fifth by 1/4 lengths, and he didn't run half bad. He quickened up a little bit that day. It wasn't a bad race. He ran a lot better than I expected him, but I don't know how I really get the form out of that race. The winner, Accidental Agent, is really a crap horse, I think, and in a million years, I would have never had that horse on top, and you know, a lot of the horses out of that race haven't been really firing. But, you know, he did run well there against a little subpar group of European horses for that race this year. But before that, he probably had one of his best runs ever. That came stateside at Churchill. Monleith Yielding Ground Turf Classic. Horse won by 3/4 length. He stalked early on, got the lead, and then he took off. Good race for this horse there off the break. And then before that, in the Hill Prince at Belmont, Monleith Inner Turf Course last October. Horse won by a neck. He stalked that day and got there in the nick of time. Good race for this horse. Like I said, coming to dirt for the first time should really help this one a lot. Speed from the inside, if he has the speed, you know, I think he'll run a big one. 5-1, a horse you definitely want to use on your pick four. Another horse I'm going to use on my pick four will be the four-horse Tapperts, this four-year-old colt by Tappet here. John Velasquez gets the leg up for Todd Pletcher. This horse's most recent outing came the 4th of August at Saratoga. Saw it going, Monleith and the Whitney. This horse finished 4th by 10 1/4 lengths, and I don't know how to use the format of that race either, because it poured, you know, 40 minutes before the race, and the absolute main track was an absolute sloppy going, and you know, this horse just hit the wall. I think with a dirt track today, you'll probably see this horse's better races coming out, but you know, that was the Whitney was a weird race this year. Before that, this horse ran in the Suburban at Belmont, mile and a quarter, July the 7th. Horse finished 5th by 9 3/4 lengths. Diversify ran a hell of a race in a sub 2 minute mile and a quarter. This horse was very wide and just had nothing in the straightaway. And then before that, first start of the year at Belmont, mile 16th, Optional Lady Claimer. Horse finished 3rd by 1 1/4 lengths. Didn't break all that well, was wide, and you know, he probably needed the race. Before that, he ran here at Saratoga in the Travers last year, and he finished 4th by 8 lengths, never firing. But before that, his best race ever came in the Belmont Stakes at Belmont, mile and a half in July of 2017. Horse won by 2 lengths. He stalked that day, got the lead, and then he held on. A good race for this horse. I think today, with a good posture, you'll probably see him sitting a little bit closer to the pace. And if he has a good clear trip, I think he'll run a big one. Been training well. Watch out for him to see the good Tapper today, because I think he's going to show up. 6-1, horse you definitely want to use on your multi-race ticket. So to recap my selections for the 11th from Saratoga, it's the Grade 1 $750,000 Woodward Stakes. Top selection, going to go to the 7-horse Kurilov. I'm going to go 7-1-4-9 in the Superfecta. I'll go 7-1-4 in my pick 4. So now let's get on to race number 12 from the Spa. The Nightcap from Saratoga, race number 12. It's the Glen Falls Stakes, Grade 2, purse $250,000. This race is for fillies and mares, 3-year-olds and upwards. Field of 9 horses. The 9 is a main track only, so 8 will go on the turf course here. The distance of ground of 2,200 meters, with the distance of ground of 1 3/8 on the inner turf course. 2,200 meters, 1 3/8. Rail's going to be out on this turf course, I believe, 18 feet, I believe. It doesn't say in the racing forms for some reason. Should have downloaded the final print edition, not the early edition of the racing form, but pardon that. My top selection here, I like the 5-horse Santa Monica. I'm going to go 5-6-3-8 in the Superfecta. 5-6-3-8 super. Top selection of 5-horse Santa Monica. This 5-year-old mare by Master Craftsman. Jose Ortiz is on this one. For Chad Brown. Before I get on to this horse, I forgot my pick 4 plays. I'm going to use the 5-horse Santa Monica in the pick 4, the 6-horse Homeland Security in the pick 4, and the 3-horse On the Moon again in my pick 4. So I'll go 5-6-3 also in my pick 4. The Chad Brown triple, or trifecta here. But like I said, my top selection here, the 5-horse Santa Monica, 5-year-old mare by Mass Craftsman, blah, 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 blah. Jose Ortiz gets the leg up. You know, this horse, you know, they tried entering this horse a few weeks ago in the Wire, but that got rained off a few times. And so they're waiting for this race. And I think this is the proper race for her. You know, the Wire, I don't think was, you know, maybe to her liking, but I think here she's going to run well. But her last start came in the Dance Smartly at Woodbine, a mile and a quarter, June the 30th. Horse won by half length there. Sat back early, but had a great turn of foot from the back of the pack and won very nicely by half length. A good race there for this one. Off a little bit of a break before that, ran the 5th of May at Belmont, a mile 3/8 in the Sheepshead Bay. His horse finished third by a half length and closed up well at the end. It wasn't a bad turn of foot there. And then before that, Keeneland, mile and a half and allowance race 63,000. First start stateside, first start Lasix. Horse won by four lengths, was basically last until the top of the lane, and then just took off for fun. Could have won by more, but Jose Ortiz didn't want to kill the poor horse. It was a very good race for this horse. You know, before that, this horse was running in the UK and in Ireland. Most recent outing across seas came the 2nd of November of last year at Linkfield on the all-weather poly track, mile 5/8 in the River Eden Stakes. Horse finished 9th by 6 3/4 lengths and just had nothing. A really shit race for this horse there. And then Dundalk in the Carlingford Stakes, just basically listed stakes. He finished 5th by 2 lengths, a little bit of a turn of foot, but again, it wasn't enough to win. You know, I think the Lasix have really helped this horse here today, and I think she's gonna run well, so watch out for her. 6-5. I know she's a crap price, but you have to take her. Another horse I think could run a big one is the other Chad Brown, the 6-horse Homeland Security, this 4-year-old filly by Smart Strike. I read Ortiz Jr. gets the leg up for Chad Brown. A horse's most recent outing came the 8th of July. That came at Belmont, a mile and a half in the River Memories. This horse won by length there. Sat about mid-pack most of the race, waited, got a clear running space, and then he took off clear at the end. A good race for this horse there. Before that, a Belmont yielding going, mile and a quarter inner turf course, and obstacle 62 claimer May the 20th. Horse finished 4th by 1 3/4 lengths there and was very wide and just didn't show a lot there. It wasn't the day to win on wet ground. And then the 27th of September at Belmont, mile and a quarter in allowance race 90,000. Horse won by 1.5 lengths, quick enough nicely from the mid pack, and he had a good going away victory. This horse likes dry ground. I would be nervous if it rains right before post time, but that looks highly unlikely. I just said it now it's going to happen, but if it's wet ground, I would be a little afraid of her because she doesn't really dig it, but she digs the firm ground, which we'll most likely see today. At 9-2, she's a horse I'm definitely going to use on my pick 4. Another horse I'll use on my pick 4, the other Chad Brown here, the 3-horse On the Moon again. Chad Brown trains this 4-year-old filly by Cape Cross. Javier Castellano gets the leg up. This horse made the North America debut a few weeks ago here at Saratoga. Mile and 8th, August 2nd, obsolete claimer. Horse finished 3rd by 1 3/4 lengths there. You know, didn't break all that well, but closed up well at the end, and, it wasn't a bad turn of foot. I think the extra a quarter of a mile should really help this horse a lot today also. But before that, this horse ran the 1st of October at Shunti, soft ground, a mile and a quarter in the Group 1 Prix de l'Opera. This horse that day finished 10th by 5 lengths and never really got up. It wasn't the day to win. The European horse, the UK horses really ran hell of races in those races. In that race, Rhoda Rendon is a really good Aidan O'Brien horse there, the 2nd place finisher, another Aidan O'Brien horse. You know, they destroyed that race this year, last year at Shunti. This horse just didn't quicken up at all. Before then, the Prix de la Noëtie at Deauville, a mile and a quarter, August 19th of last year. Finished 2nd by 2 1/4 lengths. He closed up well at the end. The winner just had the jump on him, but he ran well there. And then the Prix de Psyche at Deauville last August, mile and a quarter, July 29th. Horse finished 3rd by 3/4 length. He had a very good turn of foot from last. If the race is a mile 5/16, let's say, she would have won, but she closed up well there. It wasn't improvement off her race before, which came in the Prix de Diane at Shunti, a mile 5/16, where she didn't finish. She fell a few at the top of the lane. She was okay after that, but she couldn't keep the she had a little hampering that day. But I think coming here to the stateside, getting the mile 3/8, I think she can run a very big race, 3-1, use on the pick 4. So to recap my selections for the 12th from Saratoga, it's the Grade 2 Glen Falls Stakes top selection. I'm going to go to the 5-4 Santa Monica. I'm going to go 5-6-3-8 in the Superfecta. I'll go 5-6-3 in my pick 4. So good luck to all, and please follow me on Twitter at HorseRacingKid5 for more selections for race courses around the world. Good luck, everybody.